Penguin Random House Audio presents Black Futures, edited by Kimberly Drew and Jenna Wortham. Read for you by Kevin R. Free, Dominic Hoffman, Robin Miles, Adenrele Ojo, and Bahni Turpin, with a letter from the editors. Note to listener, this audiobook contains unabridged selections from Black Futures, including text from some illustrations in the book. To learn more about the contributors, including visual artists whose contributions could not be translated to audio, please refer to the downloadable PDF, which accompanies this audiobook and contains contributor bios.
Introduction. Letter from the editors. This is Kimberly Drew.
This is Jenna Wortham. We are the co-editors of Black Futures, the first iteration of the Black Futures Project. The Black Futures Project started a few years ago as a direct message exchange on Twitter and has evolved into a shared desire to archive a moment. In developing Black Futures, we sought to answer the question, what does it mean to be Black and alive right now?
We sought to make sense of our unique paradox. We have never been more empowered, and yet, in many ways, are still so disenfranchised. Social media has granted Black folks a platform to tell our own stories, but it has also made us subject to a new brand of surveillance and unprecedented co-option. How can we find innovative ways to define ourselves for ourselves without fear of erasure or the deterioration of the internet? We feel part of a long lineage of projects, artists, activists, thinkers, and creators centered on the Black experience. We consider Fire magazine, The Black Book, The Black Woman, an anthology, Conditions 5, The Black Woman's Issue, The Work of Kathleen Collins, and Nine More Weeks by Sanazo Chaya as some of our most influential elders.
Black Futures is not designed to be a comprehensive document. Blackness is infinite. A single book cannot attempt to contain the multitudes and multiverse. This is just one manifestation of a project that spans millennia. We are in a continuum of those who came before and those who will come after, and make a dent in the archival project that is required of us as humans on this planet. We strove to nod to those we admire, who are making history, and those taking history and doing something anew with it. We aimed for a perspective that was global, atemporal, not dominated by America and the West, not constructed by binaries, and as dynamic as possible.
We invite you to read, and in this case, listen to this book alongside another device, so you can search out names and terms that intrigue you. See where they lead. Our intention is to encourage readers to follow their interests into a deep warren of rabbit holes and discoveries. This is not an art book. This is not a scholarly journal. This book is a series of guideposts for current and future generations who may be curious about what our generation has been creating during a time defined by social, cultural, economic, and ecological revolution.
Like us, this book is not linear. Like us, this book lives and breathes beyond temporal Western frameworks. There is no past, present, or future. Nor is there a beginning, middle, or end. Start where you please. The print book was brilliantly designed by Jonathan Key and Yael Marcos to have its own geography, a map that can be navigated however you see fit. There are color schemes and indices throughout to serve as tools, but we did not want to subject the material to a major order or any suggestion of a hierarchy. As listeners of this audiobook, you will engage with the textual content of the contributors and their art in any order you choose.
Our process. We worked together and independently to collect these submissions. Within this audiobook, you'll hear text from screenshots, original essays, manifestos, memes, descriptions of artworks, poems, song lyrics, recipes, and creations of all types. Themes in this audiobook will provoke you, entice you, enrage you, spark joy, and call you to action. Some of the connections are obvious, but many are not. We think that that's okay. Wherever possible, everything in this audiobook was made by Black hands.
You will hear selections that feature some key wisdom or observations of trends on social media, prophetic prose and poetry, incendiary essays, commentaries on artworks. You will also hear recipes. In some cases, it might be a recipe for something edible, like Pierre Serrault's coconut bread recipe. In others, it might be guidelines for how to start your own Black art collection. We invite you to consider these pieces as exercises to inspire you beyond the book, to care for yourself, to start an archive, and to feed you as you create your own Black futures. Thank you for trusting us enough to come on this journey with us. In light, love, and solidarity.
When Jenna slid into my DMs, March 2015.
It must be said, I love your Instagram. You are a dream queen.
Ah, you are a dream queen. Thank you so much. Also, I feel like a dweeb for only following you on Twitter. Following you on Instagram now. Thanks for messaging.
Oh, not at all. This is when it's all supposed to happen. I'd been wanting to talk to you because I'm thinking about doing a Black art zine, and I thought you might be interested or have thoughts.
Yes. Here's my email. Happy to help, however.
Eek! Yes, I made this. Blackfuture.us. But there's nothing there yet. Just a holding page. But I actually want to print the thing and have a show.
Ah, ingenious. Yeah, I'm down to help. I wanted to do a zine for my Tumblr, but I don't think I'd ever find the time. So I'm happy to co-edit, share artists, promote the zine, and drink about your strategy. Whatever works for you.
Ah, are you in BK?
I am. Bed-Stuy, off the A at Nostrand.
Black Lives Matter Toronto participated in Pride 2016 as an honored group. They later staged a sit-in and halt festivities to urge the inclusion of more Black LGBT members. Among their demands, a commitment to Black ASL and deaf interpreters, and to increase Indigenous visibility. After 30 minutes, leaders of Pride Toronto signed off on BLM's demands, hugged the demonstrators, and the parade resumed. Demonstrators attended a protest over the death of Adama Traoré in front of the Gare du Nord train station in Paris. The family of Adama Traoré called for the truth on July 30, 2016, before a protest march in Paris. On July 29, 2016, a justice rejected the request to perform a third autopsy on the body of the young man, who died 11 days earlier during his arrest, said the prosecutor of Pontoise. In mid-April 2015, the city of Baltimore erupted in mass protests in response to the arrest, hospitalization, and resulting death of Freddie Gray, who was severely injured while in police custody. An image captured by Baltimore native Devin Allen would later be published on the cover of Time magazine. Black Lives Matter.
Black Lives Matter. Alicia Garza. Screenshot of Facebook post from Alicia Garza, July 13, 2013. Alicia Garza posted, "Black people, I love you. I love us. Our lives matter." Esteban Rodriguez, Anthony Julius Williams, Christopher Cook, and 112 others like this. Andrew Jolivet commented, "Love you back." Alicia Garza to Andrew Jolivet, hashtag Black Love. Andrew Jolivet, thanks for the reminder, hashtag Black Love. Reese Chanel, love you right back, sis. Screenshot.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.